My name is Ben Hassett. My company is BE Hassett Millwright, so we're based out of Louisville, Kentucky.
I'm a millwright. I am in the trade of building and restoring windmills and water mills.
Very cool.
But I actually, in an apprenticeship, built most of these works in here in 1997 with my mentor, Derek Ogden. He's a British millwright. There's a mentorship program, an apprenticeship program, and that's how I learned the trade of building mills. So now I travel all over the country, restoring windmills and water mills, and developing all sorts of different wind and water powered sites, sawmills, everything.
And what did you have to do that? I mean, you got the apprenticeship, but what was your previous life experience to get to that point?
I was pursuing engineering.
Okay.
And I got involved with this. And this is all, it's, everything's so basic here, but there's so much to it. The more simple something is, the more fundamental and important the principles going into it are. Like everything from the shape of the wooden teeth, they're all hand-shaped, they have a different type of curvature. Size of the gears is dictated by the strength of the materials of the wood. So there's that moment where the gears contact each other, and that's where all the stress is transferred. All that's important. That kind of dictates the size of the wheel and eventually how fast everything can go. So it's like really basic physics, but it's really fun too.
It's like art meets physics meets engineering meets craftsmanship meets just like history and love.
Yep,
and
yep. It's food too. You can get cornmeal and grits here. The head racer is that dam in the mill pond, which kind of is like the battery for the whole operation. Upstream. And then there's the race on the stream that kind of comes down, the man-built stream, is called the head race. And then the wooden section that carries the water from the outside of the building to the inside is called the flume. And then the flume, flows over the wheel. It's an overshot water wheel. It's 20 feet in diameter and 4 feet wide. And it flows over the wheel and then down the tail race and then back into the creek. The whole thing is like stored potential energy up at the dam. And then it all, like you have what's called the head, which is the total volume of water. That's how you dictate like the size of the wheel and the site. This wasn't here by accident. There was a lot of fall to the stream. And they could, there's probably like a natural waterfall there too. And that's when they sided the dam and they kind of captured that water. And then the race, instead of following the drop of the stream, is maintained at level.
Right.
So that's where all that stored energy comes from.
That means you can collect more volume of water, and then when you release it, it has more energy because of the built-up pressure.
Exactly. The capacity of the flume, it's, we'll say 3 feet wide, and it's holding 2.5 feet of water.
Okay.
And that is maybe 30-some feet long. All that weight's supported by wooden beams. And you think 1 gallon
Whoa.
Of water weighs what? And then you factor that into how many gallons, you know, then you divide it over the number of vents you have there. The vents are the little wooden frames that support the flume. You can see the legs that are holding it up.
Yeah.
And if you go upstairs, you can kind of look down into it and see the water going over the top of the wheel too.
Okay, we'll definitely check that out.
Okay. This is really primitive here. We'll see how they...
I don't know. This is a lot of amazing, simple machines that do some really hard work.
Oh, they do. Whoa. It's leaking. See, it's out of balance. I'm probably going to have to go over there. What's that? Exciting, huh?
Nice! So is it out of balance because the wood warps?
You get all the airflow to the upper side and then to the bottom, and it's close to the water, so it's wicking in moisture. And you think of how much weight this is, and then when it gets saturated, when the wood fibers get saturated with water, it actually gets heavier. So what they do is they actually, what they call freewheel, which is what we're doing now, which means we're not turning it into gear train. And what that does is allows the wheel to come into balance so that you don't have to go over there and...
Like equally wet, equally heavy.
Right.
Thank you so much for meeting with us. This was absolutely an amazing coincidence, and I am thrilled.